Welcome back. Sports Chat.
503.
So today, this one goes out 503. To... this one goes out 503. To... this one goes out to all those guys out there who love to look at baseball stats. Okay, I'm a baseball fan. I was a player. I love the game. Yeah. I love it. But I am kind of one of those guys who likes to throw the ball, hit the ball, catch the ball. Not really one of those guys to like to pore over data. Mm-hmm. The guy who keeps score in the baseball stadium, I'm that guy. I'll keep score in a baseball game.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to go home and like break down. It just gives me something to do for the 4 hours I'm sitting in the baseball game. Oh, God. Okay, so this one goes out to you guys. Stat nerds. Okay.
That's good. Offend them right off the bat.
Right off the bat. All you rotisserie geeks, all you stat nerds.
You knock them down and then you build them back up.
That's America. That's America, bro. Okay. My great topic today, I got to mention it right here. This is a big thing for me. I'm a huge baseball fan, especially when I was growing up. And my two favorite guys, of course, everybody's two favorite, or anybody who likes the two top dudes at least.
Yeah, whoever likes baseball.
Whoever likes baseball and whoever likes the best. Likes Griffey and Bonds. So who's better, Griffey or Bonds? Who do you think?
Barry Bonds.
God, we're in the Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Now, this is where I'm going to say I like Griff. And the reason why I like Griff is single-handed. He's a center fielder.
Yeah.
That's it. I get a left fielder or a center fielder. That's how you propose it to me. Yeah. One of the best left fielders of all time. One of the better center fielders of all time.
Yeah, I gotta say,
I'll go with Griff.
Yeah, all around
attitude, how he brings to the locker room.
Yeah,
Griff.
Yeah, I see your point. I mean, obviously a better fielder, not just a better fielder compared to Bonds.
The Sid Bream wiffle ball to home, that hurt.
Yeah. It's not just...
You're in left field, man. Throw the ball.
Yeah, it's not just the fact that he's better than Bonds at center field. He's better than most people at center field.
Oh, he's better than everybody not named, I think, Willie Mays, maybe?
Yeah.
And even that, Willie might not have been better than his dad. People don't even know this. His dad actually was the bomb of the bomb. I mean, a lot of people know it. Old-timers know it.
Yeah.
But a lot of my generation was like, what? Willie's dad was good? Shoot.
Yeah, so that's a big advantage for the all-round vote. And, yeah, I guess more, attitude, team player, that kind of stuff.
Both dads played pro and were bomb.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, to me, Griffey and Bonds are so, so similar.
Yep.
And we were just looking at the numbers. It's crazy to see some of these numbers. The games is crazy. 26-71 for Griff, 29-86 for Bonds. To think that those guys played that close, is nuts. After all those years, it's insane. Some of these other stats are just crazy. To me, it's the hits. In hits, they're actually fairly close. It's in walks, 25 plus and 13.
Yeah.
For Griff, I mean, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
So what's Bond's full stat on the walks here? The walks here are at 25-58. 25-58 for Bonds, and Griffey is 13-12. So,
almost
truly,
double Griffey's walks.
That really shows to me I'm a Ruth guy, and I was always taught that walks show who is a better hitter. You might be able to hit the ball out of the park. They might put you on base because it's not the good situation, but a good hitter gets walks. A good hitter chooses not to take a third ball.
Yeah.
And try to yak it out of the park. Instead, just take it as a ball and get your walk.
Yeah, Griffey's got more strikeouts than Bonds.
Way more. And I think that Griffey's going to take that third pitch and going to pop that thing up to the warning track.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, straight up, though, if you had to have one guy on your team, it is hard not to go with Barry Bonds.
Yeah, it's hard.
Dude, even without the steroids.
Yeah.
But with the steroids?
Dude,
unbelievable.
His lifetime average.
Dude, the numbers in the steroids are nuts.
Yeah, it's off the chart here. But Bonds is a 298 hitter for his career.
Yeah.
Are you serious? Yeah. Wow. Yeah. I never knew he had that.
Yeah.
I mean, he had a lot of really good years with really good averages.
Oh, yeah.
For a guy that hits home runs like he does,
it's insane.
The fact that he's got less strikeouts than Griffey.
Right.
And he's got a better average. So.
So if you look at the era, supposedly as the story goes, they're in the off season. It's the 98 year. Bonds is like, screw this. McGuire's on steroids. Sosa's on steroids. It's 98, 99, whatever. He goes on this tear. 2000 to, let's go 2005, when the wheels start falling off a little bit. He goes from 45 home runs to 5. That kind of tells you off the top. But let's just go this round for just for a second. 99, he goes up. So from 99 to 2000, let's do this route. He goes from 34 to 49 bombs. 34 to 49.
Yeah, that's
the next year goes to 73, breaks the record. So 34, 49, 73. Immediately shatters the record, okay? Yeah. Then comes back down to earth a little bit to 46, okay? Then goes 45, 45. But no joke, the year he hit 45, 45, he was hitting 370, 340, 320, 360. Yeah. Dude, the dude hit 328 when he hit the 70 bomb. And or no, 46 bomb.
Yeah.
The year he hit 73 bombs, what is it? The year he hit 73 bombs, he hit 328. The next year he hit 370. He's like, I'm going to hit 73 bombs one year, and then I'm going to get a batting title the next year.
Yeah.
That's playground. That's like literally taking it on a whole other level.
That's ridiculous, man.
I'll take Barry Bonds on steroids over any player ever.
Yeah, because you got...
At the plate.
The home run guy's either going to hit a lot of home runs and have a terrible average and strike out all the time, or you're going to have a player that's got a good average that can't get it out of the yard to save his life, a la Tony Gwynn.
Not to mention that, he was literally making the pitchers freaking wet themselves on the mound before they even started pitching.
Yeah, that would be the whole talk. You'd think that the guy... accounted for like 10 runs for every running
hit. Oh my god.
But yeah, it's ridiculous.
Of 8, I think it was? Every 8 that bad he was
falling? Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I think it was, that's ridiculous. Yeah. That's ridiculous.
And
what is Pujols now? I think Pujols now is like 1 of every 14, 15, something like that.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I mean, maybe it was every 8? That's nuts.
Yeah. It's like 1 every other game.
That's ridiculous.
So, and it's great though because... you know, these are stats. Like, you had a good point. You know, who would you rather have on your team? You know, stats-wise, I'd want Barry Bonds.
Definitely, especially steroids.
Yeah, but as like a team player, I'd want Griffey without a doubt.
Yeah, is Griffey the best Mariner? It's him and Alvin Davis.
Alvin Davis, yeah. The first
It's him and Alvin Davis.
Yeah. I would say yeah. Cause...
I mean, Griffey to me is phenomenal.
Yeah.
He's Air Jordan. So. To me, Griffey's the Air Jordan of baseball. Yeah. He's the guy who all the dudes who were super athletic were like, shit, maybe I should play baseball.
Yeah.
He was the dude who was like, yo, if you're like 6'5 and an athlete, he's the guy who Michael Jordan wanted to be.
Yeah, that's a great, great one. Yeah, that's who Michael Jordan wished.
And Ken might have been wanting to be Michael Jordan, but yeah. Ken Griffey Jr., single-handed, greatest moment to me, the back-to-back. His dad goes yard. He steps up and goes yard.
Yeah, father, son.
Who the hell goes yard after their dad in a major league game? You have to be on the same team.
Yep.
You have to both be playing in the major leagues. Besides, like, the, you know, 4 or 5 families that have had numerous,
be in the
Bell family, Boone family. These guys have had numerous people.
You got to be in the batting yard order.
And your dad has to be old enough, and you have to be young enough to be able to be, I mean, Barry Bonds and his dad had no even close to being playing. Bobby Bonds was done years before Barry's playing.
Yeah.
I mean, his dad went yard and his son is next up. Bomb. Plus, dude, there is might nothing be sweeter than that little junior bounce.
Yeah, I think he might have...
That?
Yeah, I like his swing a lot better than Bonds. Bonds gets up there.
Super calculated.
And he's a stack of muscle.
He locks in.
Yeah.
He locks in like McGuire did. I was saying when McGuire was hitting those bombs, he was bench pressing those balls off of him.
Yeah.
He wasn't even really swinging and coming in contact with the ball. He was literally starting from here and just lifting the ball out and bench pressing, throwing his hands at it.
Yeah.
Griff would still to this day just bounce.
Yeah, it's got
and
the
just
real nice,
pop.
Real nice rhythm.
Really easy.
Yeah, Bonds almost looked like he was hitting those home runs off his back foot. Like
I'll
just
take
one-legged.
Him. I'll take him. 73.
Yeah.
Barry Bonds on steroids, my favorite player ever.
check out the videos on steroids.
Dude, he's awesome.
Check out the videos.
He is awesome.
Yeah.
For any sport. Okay, YouTube. Adios. We love you guys.
Big forehead.
Peace.